Well, just briefly, I'd like to touch on the situation in the Middle East, what to say about it. And I always try to repeat that the so-called Middle East is an artificial political product specifically designed to be none other than a cauldron of indefinite intrigue, misery, murder, and confusion that is of serious benefit to no one except the system of white supremacy. And that's the way I usually say that people should always address it, just right off the top, to say it's a situation. It's not really a geographical location as such. It's an ideology, something called the Middle East, something that someone dreamed up. And all of the evidence shows that it's something that's specifically designed to just go on and on and on and on and on until, presumably, the people who believe in white supremacy want it to stop, in which they don't want it to stop because they're the ones who set it up, presumably. They're the usual suspects when something like this is going on, primarily because it involves a lot of people who, many people, not all, but many people who could be classified as non-white. And it sometimes includes places like so-called Yemen or even Morocco, which there's a lot of dark-skinned people there. Libya, a lot of dark-skinned people there. Anywhere where there are people, a lot of people who are of color, and which is sort of a crossroads. That might even include Ethiopia sometimes. They will call that a part of the Middle East, even though, you know, you look at a so-called map and you see that it's in Africa, and they'll say, well, Africa sometimes is a part of the Middle East and sometimes it's not. Depends on which Thursday it happens to be that the white supremacists make a decision about how many people they're going to kill.